We are Southmoreland and we are Scotty Strong. The past few months have been a challenge for our district and the community at large, but I believe we will persevere. And my belief starts with what you're about to see today with the graduating class of 2020, all the awards, recognitions, and scholarships they're about to receive. So I would like to welcome the teachers, administrators, presenters, students, and for the first time ever, the Southmoreland community to Class Day 2020. And let me be the first to congratulate the class of 2020 on their graduation and all the awards they're about to receive today. Good luck in your future. We are proud of you.
Congratulations to the 2020 graduates of Southmoreland High School. I am presenting the award from the Little Learners Preschool for Jan Laufer. Your commencement brings with it the beginning of a whole new world of adventures. The scholarship from the Little Learners Preschool is in memory of Larry M. Laufer and Jeffrey D. Laufer. This is the 39th year for the Little Learners Preschool. Hundreds of tiny students have graduated from the preschool and are now adults, of whom we are very proud. The scholarships are granted to graduating high school seniors who are graduates of the preschool. This year, we are pleased to present the Little Learner Preschool Memorial Scholarship to Southmoreland graduate Lauren Hoyle. Congratulations. Best wishes.
Congratulations to all in the class of 2020. I am here to announce two scholarships. The first is the Southmoreland Band Booster Scholarship. This scholarship is given each year by the Southmoreland Band Boosters to a student in the marching band. The 2020 recipient of the Southmoreland Band Booster Scholarship is Miss Brianna Demigal. The second scholarship is the George W. Rath Memorial Marching Band Scholarship. This scholarship is given each year in honor of George Rath, a volunteer and avid supporter of the marching band. A special thank you to Miss Kathy Thomas, Mr. Rath's daughter, and Al, her husband, for continued support of this scholarship. The 2020 recipient of the George W. Rath Memorial Marching Band Scholarship is Miss Madison Garlowich. Congratulations, ladies, and congratulations to all seniors in the Southmoreland class of 2020.
We are scholars. In a class of 119, 61 of us have enrolled in AP courses, and 33 of us have a GPA of 3.5 or higher. Our students will find themselves everywhere from studying creative writing at Bucknell, to pre-med at Robert Morris, to accounting and financing at WVU, and to engineering at Penn State.
Horatio Elgar is a well-known writer and philosopher. Part of his philosophy focuses on the fact that we can't always control the situations in which we're born into, but that through commitment to others, hard work, academics, and courage, we can rise above that situation. Every single year, Horatio Elgar Foundation recognizes students who have done this very thing at the state level and even at the national level. This year, 43,000 students applied at the national level, and out of those 43,000, 106 students were selected. I am very proud and excited to announce that one of Southmoreland's 2020 graduates has been selected as a national winner of the Horatio Elgar Scholarship. And that student is Scarlett Davidovich. Through her hard work in the classroom, commitment to community service, and the courage to realize that what we're born into does not define who we are, Scarlett is the epitome of everything Horatio Elgar represents.
I'm here to present the 2020 CWCTC Awards. The Central Westmoreland Career and Technology Center congratulates the following seniors on their accomplishments for this school year. Student of the Year Award goes to Cheyenne Bash. The second award is Student of the Month, and two Scotties were awarded that. They are Cheyenne Bash once again, and Carly Collins. The next recognition is the National Technology Honor Society. Four of our guys were able to get inducted into that. They are Brett Hassinger, Nathan Henry, Blake Nelson, and Walter Ulishny. Okay, the next award is for outstanding work and commitment to their programs, and two Scotties were awarded that. The first one is Cheyenne Bash was awarded and recognized as an outstanding student by vocation in the carpentry program. And Carly Collins was awarded and recognized as an outstanding student by vocation in the cosmetology program. The final award I have for the CWCTC recognitions is the Daniel R. Miller Fretz Memorial Scholarship. And I'm going to read about why it was created. The Daniel R. Miller Fretz Memorial Scholarship is awarded to a Southmoreland senior who is pursuing a career in either a traditional trade or its modern equivalent. The scholarship was founded by Daniel R. Miller's daughter to honor the memory of her father and the Miller and Fretz families of the Scottsdale area. Mr. Miller was born and raised in Scottsdale and believed the core values instilled in him by his immediate Miller and Fretz relatives were contributing factors to success in business and in life. He was interested in designing and crafting specialty items from wood and metal that became his life's calling. During his time with the U.S. Navy, he excelled as a deep-sea diver and metalsmith. Following the war, he established D&M Metal Specialties Incorporated, which made significant contributions to major construction projects in the Washington, D.C. and surrounding areas. The recipient of this year's Daniel R. Miller Fretz Memorial Scholarship goes to Cheyenne Bash. Congratulations, Cheyenne, and congratulations to everyone for their CWCTC awards and recognitions.
Good morning, and congratulations, Class of 2020. My name is Debbie Walter, and I am here today to present a scholarship in memory of my son, Brendan Walter. B was a 2014 graduate of Southmoreland High School and had a very bright future ahead of him. He was a four-year player and letterman on the boys' soccer team, as well as the Southmoreland inline hockey team. That all came crashing down in the blink of an eye. B was tragically killed in a car accident 1.5 miles from our home on July 19th, 2014. No, he wasn't on his phone. No, he wasn't drunk. And no, he wasn't on drugs. He was just a teenage boy going too fast. Teen automobile accidents are occurring more frequently and are becoming more deadly. These accidents don't only affect the victims, but many others too. This split-second accident has changed our family's lives forever. There are many things we will never see Brendan do. I urge you that every single time you get behind the wheel of a car or in the passenger seat, that you make the right decisions. Brendan's last tweet earlier that day was #alwayshappy. Our family has adopted this simple quote to live our lives every single day to the fullest with no regrets. Not many of you would have had the opportunity to know B, but we continue to remember him every day and each year on class day with the Always Happy Scholarship. We can only hope that you too will adopt our family's quote, #alwayshappy. With that being said, the 2020 Brendan B. Walter Memorial Scholarships go to Noah Kinter, Colin McCoy, and Mercedes Smartnick. We wish each of you the best of luck as you continue your careers in the fall, and congratulations, Class of 2020.
Hello, Class of 2020. My name is Ian Uhouse, and I'm here at the Laux Homestead, home of the Scottsdale Historical Society, to present the Jane A. Uhouse Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship was established in 2014 to honor my mother, who passed away in 2013 from cancer. My mother was passionate about family, travel, baking, helping others, and supporting nonprofit organizations like the Scottsdale Historical Society. The scholarship is available to a student who is a declared major in the culinary arts, environmental sciences, social sciences, or health and human service fields. The student should also demonstrate strong family values, academic success, and be involved within the community. Reading through the student's essay and recommendation letters, one thing that stood out is that she is a leader and a role model in and out of the classroom and community. This student has been accepted to Indiana University of Pennsylvania and is majoring in psychology, and would like to work with youth and with psychiatric needs. On behalf of my family and the Scottsdale Historical Society, it is my honor to award the $1,000 Jane A. Uhouse Memorial Scholarship to Brianna Demigal. Congratulations.
It's truly an honor to be here with all of you, the class of 2020, as we look forward what your future holds, and we look back on your past accomplishments. Today I have the honor of presenting the Samuel S. Hicks Memorial Merit Scholarship. Sam graduated from South Mormon with the class of 1993 and grew up in the Scottsdale area. While he was at South Mormon, he lettered in soccer, track, and tennis, was also a wrestler for a while, was a member of NHS, French National Honor Society, the academic quiz team, and he was the student council treasurer. And as a junior, he enlisted in the Army National Guard. After his days at South Mormon, Sam attended Pitch on Sound before starting a career in law enforcement as an officer in Ocean City, Maryland, before moving to Baltimore and joining the BCPD as a narcotics detective. 4 years later, Sam had completed his special agent training at the FBI Academy in Quantico, Virginia. Sam was a devoted father, a loving husband, a son, a grandson, uncle, and a personal friend of mine, and many others in the South Mormon community. Tragically, on November 19, 2008, just a little over a year in service, FBI Special Agent Hicks was killed on duty. He was just 33 years old. The Sam S. Hicks Memorial Fund continues to offer a $1,000 merit scholarship each year to a South Mormon senior who possesses the following qualifications. Ranks in the top 20% of the graduating class, participated in community service through their school, the church, and or civic organizations, and plans to attend college after graduation. It is my honor to present the 2020 Samuel S. Hicks Merit Scholarship to Chase Kuhar. I wish him the best of luck at Bloomsburg University, where he will be majoring in digital forensics with a minor in political science as he pursues his dream of becoming a cybersecurity agent with the FBI. Congratulations, Chase.
We are athletes. Being a student athlete is an accomplishment itself, but the class of 2020 has done more than that. We have over 12 seniors who have reached all section in their sport. We have won a WPO championship, had an undefeated season, broke various football records, and reached state playoffs in various sports.
I am honored to present the 2020 Chris Kiefer Memorial Scholarship. Christopher Kiefer was an exemplary son, brother, student, and friend. Chris tragically lost his life in an automobile accident in November of 2006. As a student, Chris excelled in the classroom. He enrolled in numerous AP courses, where he'd often be front and center in classroom discussion. He was friendly and compassionate to everyone, never put anyone down. He only strived to pick people up. He never compromised his beliefs and values by getting involved with drugs or alcohol. Chris was also an exceptional athlete. He excelled as a member of the varsity soccer and cross-country teams. He volunteered for Outdoor Odyssey, where he mentored young, at-risk children. Through their efforts in the classroom and in the community, these students embody the values and work ethic that Chris exuded in his daily life. The scholarship recipients for 2020 are Erica Sherbondi, Tessa Yutzi, Destiny Wetzel, Sarah Pasula, Sarah Dubral, and Shelby Baker. Congratulations to the 2020 Chris Kiefer Memorial Scholarship winners.
Very well. This next scholarship is very near and dear to me. I was actually fortunate enough to be the first Southmoreland graduate to receive this scholarship 26 years ago. And afterward, I was able to help with the annual memorial bike run that the family held to sustain this scholarship. And I got to know them very well, and I'm just so honored to be able to announce the next Southmoreland graduate to receive this scholarship. So, on behalf of the Randy S. Parfit Memorial Scholarship, we would like to tell you about Randy. Randy lived in the Scottsdale community for many years. He was the assistant chief of police at Scottsdale Police Department and an officer for the Westmoreland County Drug Task Force. Randy had a prestigious law enforcement career, receiving numerous accolades, including being honored 3 times by the American Police Hall of Fame for excellent arrests, as well as being named Outstanding Young Law Enforcement Officer. He was an active member in the Scottsdale community. He was a liaison for the Scottsdale Auxiliary Police, as well as a liaison officer for the Southmoreland Area Youth Commission. And he was also a member of the Scottsdale Elks. This scholarship wouldn't be possible without the tireless efforts of Randy's mother, Anita Parfit. This $1,000 scholarship is presented to a Southmoreland student entering into law enforcement and a student who has a sense of community. It is our great pleasure to announce that the recipient of the Randy S. Parfit Memorial Scholarship is Mr. Chase Kuhar. Congrats, Chase, and again, congrats to the Southmoreland Class of 2020. We wish you all the best.
Charles Eliot once said, "Books are the quietest and most constant of friends. They are the most accessible and wisest of counselors and the most patient of teachers." Our community is very lucky to have the Scottsdale Public Library, and the students of Southmoreland are very fortunate to have the Friends of the Scottsdale Library Scholarship. The scholarship celebrates a student who has demonstrated the ability to succeed at the college level. This year, the scholarship is awarded to Elle Kenny. In the fall, Elle will be attending the University of Pittsburgh studying Japanese. Congratulations, Elle, and good luck in all your future endeavors.
Along with being the high school autistic support teacher, I am also a committee member of Scottsdale's Community Picnic in the Park. The picnic is a one-day event that happens in August at Lauchs Park. It is a time to celebrate being together with family and friends within our community. Our scholarship recognizes one senior who shows involvement or interest in the community. This year's scholarship goes to Charlotte Fulham. To the class of 2020, although this isn't how you wanted your high school careers to end, please know that this will help you get through the most difficult times in your future. Congratulations and best wishes.
Hi, I'm Logan Sandermont, and my great-uncle Barry was a nice man, and I loved spending time with him. He loved spending time with all of his great-nieces and nephews, and especially his granddaughter. My Uncle Barry also loved Southmoreland. He was a 1976 graduate and a proud member of the marching band and the vocational technical program. He worked as a security guard and as an aide on the school vans. He always talked about how much he enjoyed working with the students on the band. He devoted his life to helping others, and my family would like to present the Barry S. Fallon Memorial Scholarship to someone who will also want to use his or her vocational technical training to help others. The Barry S. Fallon Memorial Scholarship offers a scholarship to students who are currently a part of the vocational technical program or who will be enrolled in a trade school or technical program post-baccalaureate and show a strong commitment to serving others. This year, we are so excited to present the Barry S. Fallon Memorial Scholarship to Carly Collins.
Well, hello there, class of 2020. I am here to present the next award with a little help from my friend Hedwig here. So unfortunately, this is not a scholarship to go to Hogwarts. I tried, kids, but I just couldn't get it. Instead, this is the next best thing. So I'm here to present the 2020 KeyText Award. So KeyText Energy is a full-service energy and consulting company that has provided energy procurement services and technical support to numerous school districts within Westmoreland County. These services have resulted in school districts being able to control and optimize their energy costs as they manage the risks and complexities associated with energy markets. That's a lot of muggle words. As a way to give back, KeyText Energy has established a scholarship award for students that attend the schools they proudly serve. KeyText Energy greatly values academic excellence and wishes to recognize outstanding students who have a desire to further their education. This year's award goes to one of my favorite Slytherins, Jocelyn Basado. Jocelyn exemplifies these qualities and will be continuing her education at Bucknell University in the field of English creative writing. Congratulations, Jocelyn. We wish you the best.
Hello, sophomore in class of 2020. This is B. Jarbeck-Burke. I am the incoming president for the Scottsdale Rotary Club. Our Rotary Club is a service organization, and we provide and do projects locally, nationally, and internationally. Our motto is service above self, and the applicants that applied for our scholarship demonstrated that. So we appreciate you all. Want to let you know we did have 11 applicants. We are providing 4 scholarships. Those scholarships will go to, Maria Catalino, Sarah DeBrawl, and Faith Miller. They each receive a $250 scholarship, and we are providing a $500 scholarship to Erica Shabondi. So thank you all for applying. Those of you that did not receive a monetary reward, you will receive a gift from our Rotary Club, and you can all expect to see something in your mail in the next week or so. So thank you all for your resilience and your hard work and graduating. That's huge. So good luck to all of you and have a blessed summer. Take care.
Each year, the Southmoreland Golf Parents Association recognizes the dedication and commitment of Southmoreland seniors and golf team members, both on the course and in the classroom. This year, the association is proud to award the 2020 Southmoreland Golf Parents Association Scholarships to Carly Collins and Chase Kuhar. Congratulations, Carly and Chase. Good luck on your future endeavors.
We are humanitarians. We are the class that raised a record-setting amount for Make-A-Wish. We're the class that took photographs of cancer survivors to show that even in the darkest times, there's hope and love. We are the class that was always first to help with food drives, buddy day, and even to read and have lunch with our primary center friends. Most of us volunteered at churches, hospitals, and community organizations, not for honor or recognition, but because it was the right thing to do.
At this time, I would like to honor the recipients of this year's Scottsdale Business and Professional Women's Scholarship. Students were asked how they would show what it means to be a positive and effective woman in the workplace. The first recipient is Amelia Eckerd. Amelia said, "A successful professional woman motivates those around her to perform to their optimal abilities. She builds an environment of trust in the workplace and takes the lead by highlighting each of other coworkers' strengths. She believes in herself and the work she produces. I strive to become the professional woman. I will foster innovation and personal growth by promoting individual thought, teamwork, moral responsibility, and a strong code of ethics." Congratulations, Amelia. The second recipient is Erica Shabondi. "I feel like I can be very effective and positive in a workplace because I dedicated hard work who likes to finish efficiently and well done. I am also a very positive person who always tries to bring happiness to the people around them, even in the darkest times. Being a woman gives me a different perspective, which ultimately could help my coworkers and deplete any problems that may arise in the workplace." Congratulations to both of these hardworking and inspirational women.
On behalf of the East Huntington Township Linus Club, I would like to award the Linus Scholarship to Jocelyn Basado. Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it.
Hi, Southmoreland class of 2020. The next scholarship today is the Diabetes Scholars Scholarship. The Diabetes Scholar Program aims to empower high school seniors living with type 1 diabetes by offering scholarships to assist them in continuing their education. This program, offered through Beyond Type 1, recognizes 50 high school seniors from around the country. I am pleased to announce that Southmoreland senior Jocelyn Basado has been named a member of the Diabetes Scholars Class of 2020.
Greetings, Southmoreland Class of 2020. My name is Dawn Kiefer, and I'm here today to present the Rocky Waller Memorial Golf Scholarship. This scholarship is given annually to 2 members of the Southmoreland graduating class who have also been members of the golf team. This scholarship is in memory of my dad, who passed away in 2000 from esophageal cancer. We have given this scholarship out annually since he's passed to someone at Southmoreland because he was a teacher at the high school for 28 years and also at the golf coach for 26 years. We are thrilled to be able to still do this 20 years later and to keep his memory alive through this scholarship and to students who feel that golf has played an important part in their lives. So we are pleased today to announce that the golf scholarship for the year 2020 is going to Carly Collins and Chase Kuchar. We are so excited to be able to honor you with this scholarship this year and wish you nothing but the best in the future. We will be mailing your prize in the mail and you should receive it soon. Thank you very much. Good luck.
Portland class of 2020, the next scholarship is the PA Youth Moose Awareness Program. The Pennsylvania Moose Youth Awareness Program offers scholarships each year to high school seniors based on academic achievement and leadership qualities. The Pennsylvania Youth Awareness Program organizes high school students into a highly effective Speakers Bureau with the goal of educating preschool and elementary school age children on topics such as bullying, peer pressure, and drug use. I am proud to announce that Southmoreland senior Carly Collins is a recipient of one of the 2020 Pennsylvania Moose Youth Awareness Program scholarships. Congrats, Carly.
Good evening. My name is Nikki Lewandowski. I'm a teacher at Southmoreland Middle School. Tonight, I would like to present the Southmoreland Education Association Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who has an interest in pursuing their future in teaching. This year, the 2020 recipient is Brianna Howes. I would like to take this time to not only congratulate Brianna, but also the class of 2020. I wish you all the best in your futures, and I can't wait to see the great things you all do.
Bloomsburg University is proud to offer the Board of Governors Scholarship in Science and Technology to a Southmoreland senior. This student will be majoring in the Digital Forensics Program, housed within the Department of Mathematical and Digital Science. Bloomsburg Digital Forensics graduates work to keep us all safe by solving cyber crimes, working with local police departments, the corporate sector, and the United States government. Bloomsburg University graduates are sought after due to the program's strong reputation and track record in the digital forensics field. It is with great pride that we announce the Board of Governors Scholarship in Science and Technology for 2020 to Chase Kuchar. Congratulations, Chase.
Hello. I'm here to present St. Vincent College Awards to the class of 2020. As an alum of St. Vincent College, I am honored to recognize two of the nicest young ladies to walk the halls of Southmoreland as they begin their journey to St. Vincent College this fall. First, Christine Shields will be majoring in computer sciences. Based on her accomplishments in the classroom, St. Vincent is pleased to announce Christine has earned the following awards and scholarships from St. Vincent: the St. Vincent College Faculty Scholarship, the First Generation Grant, and the St. Vincent College Endowment Grant. Next up is Abigail Basham, who will be majoring in history, which means she has some big shoes to fill. Based on her accomplishments, St. Vincent is pleased to announce Abby has earned the St. Vincent College Scholarship, the First Generation Grant, the Residential Grant, and the Endowment Grant. Congratulations to both Christine and Abby as they embark on their next steps towards St. Vincent in the fall.
West Virginia University is pleased to recognize Amelia Eckert as the future member of the West Virginia University Class of 2024. Amelia will be majoring in management within the John Chambers College of Business and Economics and is also accepted to the Honors College. In recognition of her academic achievements during her high school years at Southmoreland High School, Amelia has been awarded the Scholarship for Distinction and the West Virginia University College of Business and Economics Dean's Scholarship. Congratulations to Amelia and her future endeavors at West Virginia University. We're also pleased to welcome Abigail Snyder to West Virginia University, where she will be majoring in dance and general business. She hopes to one day own and operate her own dance studio. She's earned West Virginia University Creative Arts Scholarship, which is a talent-based scholarship awarded to students within the creative arts. Congratulations to future West Virginia University Mountaineer, Abigail Snyder.
Robert Morris University combines the best of a big research university and a small college. That's why RMU is a gateway to great careers and great lives. Ranked among the top universities in the country by U.S. News & World Report, RMU offers internships, mentors, and a wealth of opportunities to add your name to the growing list of student success stories. At this time, I would like to honor students who will start their path to success next year at Robert Morris. From athletics to academics to community service, these three young ladies are exceptional in every way. First is Faith Miller. Faith is being awarded the Independent Scholarship for Academic Excellence. Congratulations, Faith. Good luck in the classroom as well as on the softball diamond. Next is Haley Crowshore. Haley is being awarded a Merit Scholarship. Additionally, she is one of only 120 incoming freshmen being awarded the Scholar Freshman Applicant Designation. Finally, Haley is an honor student who will be receiving the prestigious Women's Leadership Scholarship. Congratulations, Haley. Finally, Kaylee Johnston. Kaylee's scholarship includes the Colonial Award, the Public Price Match Plus Award, the C.W. Olson Scholarship, and the Patriot Scholars Award. Congratulations, Kaylee. Finally, to close, I'd like to congratulate these three exceptional young women once again. Robert Morris is fortunate to have you.
Washington and Jefferson College is pleased to welcome Ms. Abigail Fulham to the class of 2024 at WNJ. Abigail plans to major in psychology with a concentration in conflict and resolution studies and a minor in forensic science. To assist her in achieving her career goals, Abigail is receiving the prestigious Washington and Jefferson College Thrive Scholarship. This scholarship is a top-tier scholarship based on academic and leadership qualities exhibited by the student during their high school years. We are excited to see what Abigail does with her future at Washington and Jefferson College. Congratulations. Washington and Jefferson College is proud to welcome Ms. Shelby Baker to the class of 2024 at WNJ. Shelby will be majoring in English with the ultimate goal of attending law school and someday becoming a prosecuting attorney. In recognition of her academic achievements during her school years at Southmoreland, Shelby has been awarded the Washington and Jefferson Dean Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to those who have shown academic excellence. Congratulations to Shelby and good luck in her future endeavors at Washington and Jefferson.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to start off by saying how proud I am of everybody. Congratulations to the class of 2024. Even though the end of the school year has been a pretty crappy time, it's still exciting. Chapter in your lives is starting now. You're going to be going away to college and experiencing that. So going to miss you, and I hope you well in everything you do from this point on. Bucknell University proudly offers the prestigious Presidential Fellowship Award to a Southmoreland senior. This student will continue her education, focusing on English and creative writing. As part of the Presidential Fellowship Award, this senior will work closely with a professor or university administrator on a challenging, long-term, self-driven project. I'm pleased to announce Jocelyn Basado as the recipient of the 2020 Presidential Fellows Award. Bucknell University is also pleased to award Jocelyn the Arts Merit Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes first-year students pursuing an education in the College of Arts and Sciences. Congratulations to Jocelyn Basado, and welcome to the Bucknell University class of 2024.
Hello, Southmoreland High School. My name is Trey Coles. I'm an admissions counselor at Penn State Fayette. To Southmoreland's class of 2020, just wanted to say congratulations on graduating. We're so excited for you. We wish you the best of luck in your future. Also, a huge congratulations to Maria Catalina, Jacob Lewandowski, Serenity Robinson, Charlotte Fulham, Destiny Wetzel, and Alexis Hall on receiving academic scholarships to Penn State this fall. So congratulations, enjoy your summer, and we'll see you all soon. Take care. Bye.
Hi, Southmoreland High School. This is Michelle Etling, and I'm one of the admissions coordinators at Westmoreland County Community College. First and foremost, congratulations, class of 2020. You guys did it. That is such a huge milestone and accomplishment, and you all should be proud of the work that you've done. Please know that your staff and your faculty at Southmoreland and your family and friends are proud of the accomplishments that you guys have endured over the last few months, but especially over the last 4 years. But my purpose here today is to announce the winners of the Trustees Meritorious Scholarship. So the Trustees Meritorious Scholarship is for those who live in Westmoreland County and who have earned a 3.0 GPA or better. These well-rounded students will serve as a Westmoreland Student Ambassador and will receive full tuition for the duration of their enrollment. So that is 2 years, 4 semesters of tuition coverage. And this is because of their academic success at the high school level. So it is my pleasure to announce the 2020 Trustees Meritorious Scholarship winners. We have Maggie Karinchak and Caitlin Slezak. Congratulations, ladies, and we're so excited to have you be a part of the Wolfpack. Take care and stay safe. Have a great day.
California University of Pennsylvania is pleased to recognize the following Southmoreland High School students' admission to California University of Pennsylvania. Alexander Kramer will be majoring in secondary education. Based on his accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Alexander has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Madison Garlowich will be majoring in psychology. Based on her accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Madison has earned the following scholarships from California University of Pennsylvania, the Volcker Merit Scholarship and the Booker Leadership Scholarship. Charity Henderson will be majoring in special education. Based on her accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Charity has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Austin McBeth will be majoring in health science. Based on his accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Austin has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Alyssa Johnson will be majoring in secondary education. Based on her accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Alyssa has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Caitlin Cross will be majoring in elementary education. Based on her accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Caitlin has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Joshua Sanner will be pursuing a major in aerospace engineering. Based on his accomplishments, we are pleased to announce Joshua has earned the Volcker Merit Scholarship from California University of Pennsylvania. Congratulations to Alexander, Madison, Charity, Austin, Alyssa, Caitlin and Joshua as they embark on their next step as California University of Pennsylvania Volcans.
Hi everybody, it's Taylor from the admissions office at Kent State University. Just wanted to send a special congratulations to the class of 2020 and an even more special congratulations to Colin McCoy as he has committed to Kent State University and has been awarded our President's Achievement Award. We can't wait to have you on campus this fall and go Flashes!
Hi, I'm Joyce Egger, admissions counselor with the University of Pittsburgh at Greensburg. Congratulations, class of 2020. Despite all these unusual circumstances this spring, you did it. Yay! And if you can overcome these challenging times, you can overcome anything life has to offer. So best of luck with your future plans. I would like to recognize two scholarship recipients. The first is Lauren Hohall, and the second is Mackenzie Bailey. Both will be attending Pitt Greensburg this fall, and I wish you both the best of luck. Take care.
Seton Hill University recognizes a Southmoreland senior as a winner of a Seton Hill Women in Science Scholarship. This student will continue her education in the pre-medicine program at the School of Natural and Health Sciences. The Women in Science Scholarship Program recognizes female high school students dedicated to pursuing careers in the science field. I am pleased to announce Marissa Reibel as the recipient of a 2020 Women in Science Scholarship. Congratulations to Marissa and her future endeavors at Seton Hill University, and welcome to the class of 2024. Seton Hill University is pleased to recognize Brianna House as a future member of Seton Hill's class of 2024. Brianna will be majoring in education within the University School of Education in Applied Social Sciences. In recognition of her academic success and commitment to learning at Southmoreland, Brianna has been awarded the Aloysia Lowe Scholarship. Congratulations to Brianna and welcome to the class of 2024. Seton Hill University welcomes Abigail Whitlatch to Seton Hill's University class of 2024. Abigail plans to pursue her passion for music, studying music therapy at the University School of Visual and Performing Arts. In recognition of her academic success at Southmoreland and commitment to music, Abigail has been awarded the Mary Schmidt Scholarship and the Visual and Performing Arts Scholarship. Congratulations to Abigail. We wish her success in her future endeavors. Congratulations.
Gannon is a Catholic university dedicated to excellence in teaching, scholarship, and service. Faculty and staff prepare students to be global citizens through programs grounded in the liberal arts and sciences. Inspired by the Catholic intellectual tradition, Gannon offers a comprehensive, value-centered learning experience that emphasizes faith, leadership, inclusiveness, and social responsibility. At this time, I would like to honor incoming Gannon freshman, Sarah DeBrawl. Sarah will be awarded the Academic Excellence Award based upon academic merit, as well as her SAT-ACT scores. Congratulations, Sarah, for this achievement. Good luck at Gannon.
We are heroes. In June, students will be reporting to basic training all over the country, including South Carolina. In addition, various other students will be protecting our rights, freedoms, and safety, from studying cybersecurity at Bloomsbury to studying criminal justice at Washington and Jefferson. Other students will be pursuing degrees in medicine so that they can be at the front line of any and all emergencies. Those in the class of 2020 never hesitate to demonstrate their heroism in various circumstances.
Hello, Southmoreland. This is First Sergeant Sean Cartwright, better known to most of you as Mr. Cartwright. Welcome to Class Day 2020. Congratulations, seniors, you've made it. It is with great honor and privilege that I have the duty to recognize the following students for their commitment to the United States by choosing to enlist and serve in a military organization. Bryce Bates. Bryce is enlisted with the United States Navy and is scheduled to report to basic training on July 29, 2020, where he will work as a logistics specialist aboard a submarine. Martine Burke. Martine has enlisted with the United States Marine Corps and is scheduled to report to boot camp on June 30th, 2020, where she will begin her career in administration and then transition to the military police. Congratulations to both of you, and thank you very much for your sacrifice and your service to this great nation.
At this time, I would like to recognize the Southmoreland Reading Team. Our senior reading team collectively won three ribbons, first place ribbons, at the Westmoreland Interscholastic Reading Team Competition held at the beginning of March this year at Seton Hill University. They also collectively read 30 books in a matter of a couple of months. So I'm so very proud of this team. They will be receiving the Westmoreland Interscholastic Reading Team Competition certificates. And to recognize those members, they are Shelby Baker, Abby Basham, Jocelyn Basado, Maria Catalina, Caitlin Cross, Scarlett Davidovich, Sarah DeBrawl, Amelia Eckerd, Maitland Fronzik, Abby Fulham, Charlotte Fulham, Mackenzie Galley, Brianna Howells, Marissa Reibel, Jake Lewandowski, Faith Miller, Sarah Pasola, Taylor Redmond, Josh Sanner, Erica Sherbondi, and Tessa Yutzi. So I want to say congratulations to our senior members of our 2019-20 reading team. I wish you the best of luck. Keep on reading. You've made our school proud. Good luck. Our Southmoreland Student Council often works behind the scenes, hosting events such as Red Ribbon Week, Bump It Up, Snow Court, the many donut deliveries, various fundraisers throughout the year. And this year has been no exception. I am so proud of the hard work and the energy of our student council, and I really would like to personally thank all members of our student council. Specifically, I'd like to thank the senior members and recognize them, and also our 5 senior officers. They will be receiving their student council honor cords, as well as their officer medals to proudly display at graduation. Our president is Erica Sherbondi, Vice President Sarah Pasola, Secretary Maria Catalina, Treasurer Jocelyn Basotto, Historian Charlotte Fulham, and our senior members are Haley Crowshore, Amelia Eckerd, Abby Fulham, Jake Lewandowski, and Faith Miller. Thank you so much for all your hard work, all the dedication. Certainly is appreciated. Typically at this time, our current student council seniors would be passing on the gavel to next year's seniors. Unfortunately, this year we cannot physically pass on the gavel. And so our officers would like to symbolically pass the gavel on to the class of 2021. Our president, Erica Sherbondi, would like to wish you all the best your senior year. May you carry on many of the traditions we have this year and create some of your own. Please consider the gavel passed on to the class of 2021. And I would like to send a big thank you and good luck to the wonderful class of 2020. Best wishes to you all.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Many years ago, several of you walked into my classroom freshman year with a quote on the board saying, "The two most important days of your life are the day you are born and the day you find out why." Many of you are well on your way to figuring out that why, and I couldn't be prouder. I am here today to honor the representatives of your senior class, the class officers, Jocelyn Basotto, Sarah Pasola, Amelia Eckerd, Haley Crowshore, and Erica Sherbondi. From athletics to academics to community service, your exceptional class could not have been represented by a better group of students. I wish all of you the best moving forward. You might be leaving Southmoreland, and even leaving my classroom, but you will never leave my heart. Thank you for everything that you have brought to my life these past 4 years.
The graduating class would also like to recognize Miss Lily DeQuillard, the junior class president of the class of 2021. We wish you the best of luck in all of your future endeavors and are proud to present you with the key to the school.
I accept this on behalf of class of 2021.
Greetings, students, parents, friends, and educators. It has been my privilege to address the seniors receiving their honor cords each May. I must tell you that it is a highlight of my year, a chance to wish good fortune to you and to reflect on your many academic accomplishments. As I was driving into work today, I realized that I would not be speaking in front of you this year, and I was saddened by this realization. Then I thought, wait a minute. With all the ways that we have been able to connect virtually, there is surely an opportunity to share a few words with you. You've earned these honors, and I would like to recognize you for them. Typically, I like to look back through history for examples of great thinkers and doers, and then relate their stories to your respective journeys. I've covered adventurers like Roald Amundsen, entrepreneurs like Walt Disney, and many more. I stared at my keyboard last evening for several minutes until it hit me. You, seniors, are the heroes I want to reflect upon. Talk about overcoming adversity. One day we're together, and the next day we are away from each other, hopeful for a reunion. As time moves on, it becomes clear that so many things you were planning on and looking forward to were not going to happen the way that you wanted them to. They were going to be interrupted, changed, or even lost. And yet, I saw in you patience, understanding, and compassion, and the same effort to be great in the new way of doing things that you had shown in all the familiar ways. You handled this unprecedented moment in world history with grace and kindness, and you never stopped learning. The protagonist in this great adventure is each of you. You taught us how to be flexible, how to deal with frustration, and to make something good out of a difficult moment. It should be noted that in this time, it was our senior student leaders who remained calm and were able to navigate these uncharted waters. For your families, your friends, and for those of us who are part of your academic path, watching you adjust and grow despite all these many challenges is simply further evidence that you are exactly who we believe you are, heroes for the future. I wish you all good things in that future, and on behalf of the faculty and staff of the Southmoreland School District, I commend you for all you have done and will do to make our world a better one. Best wishes, and if I can ever be of service to you, please do not hesitate to ask.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm Mrs. Sutton, the assistant principal at the high school. I will be sharing with you the names of students who have been entered into the President's Education Awards program. This program is based on academic achievement. L. Kenny, Amelia Eckert, Sarah Pasola, and Tessa Yutzi. Students earning the Presidential Educational Excellence Award have maintained a GPA of 3.5 and above. Tristan Ahmer, Mackenzie Bailey, Shelby Baker, Aubrey Bird, Jocelyn Basado, Maria Catalina, Riley Conforti, Haley Crowshor, Scarlett Davidovich, Sarah Dubral, Hunter Fletcher, Maitland Fronzik, Abigail Fulham, Mackenzie Galley, Brianna Howells, Marissa Reibel, Brett Huffman, Alexis Hall, Kaylee Johnston, Maggie Karinchek, Chase Kuhar, Jacob Lewandowski, Chloe McElroy, Faith Miller, Courtney Myers, Jacob Overly, Brandon Peterson, Robert Prinke, Erica Sherbondi, Christine Shields, Caitlin Slazak, Abigail Snyder, Samuel Spahn, Katie Sprinkle, and Abigail Whitlatch. Presidential Educational Achievement Awards are awarded to students who have maintained a GPA of 3.0 to 3.4. Kevin Barnhart, Cheyenne Bash, Abigail Basham, Monica Bentz, Hunter Brinker, Martine Burke, Carly Collins, Alexander Kramer, Brianna Demigal, Brendan Eicher, Charlotte Fulham, Madison Garlowich, Lauren Hohall, Alyssa Johnson, Noah Kinter, Emily Lambie, Ryan Marchuka, Austin Macbeth, Colin McCoy, Julia Morvosh, Patrick Nagy, Taylor Redman, Olivia Robertucci, Mercedes Smartnick, Andrew Smith, Nicole Swank, Destiny Wetzel, Lucas Wingrove, and Galatea Zeglin. Congratulations again to the class of 2020. Congratulations to all the awardees of the President's Education Awards Program.
It's with great pleasure that I introduce the honor graduates for the class of 2020. These young men and women have been difference makers in our school and community. They are students that have excelled at leadership, service, and scholarship. During their tenure at Southmoreland High School, these students have demonstrated great leadership in the classroom, on the field, and on the stage. In the face of adversity, these students impressively continue to take initiatives and activities with groups such as Student Council, YEA, various sports teams, and in various musical groups. Scholars, a great honor has been bestowed upon you. You have given countless hours of time in an effort to promote progress in our school. Do not make this the end of your dedication to the greater good. Continue to serve your fellow men and women in as many ways as possible. Congratulations to the honor graduates for the class of 2020. The honor graduates are, in alphabetical order, Jocelyn Basado, Riley Comforti, Haley Croucher, Sarah Dubral, Amelia Eckerd, Abigail Fulham, Marissa Rival, L. Kenny, Jacob Lewandowski, Faith Miller, Sarah Pasola, Erica Shirbandi, and Tessa Yutzi. The valedictorian for the class of 2020 is L. Kenny. The salutatorians for the class of 2020 are Amelia Eckerd, Sarah Pasula, and Tessa Yutzi. Once again, congratulations to the honor graduates of the class of 2020.
Okay, that concludes our awards, recognition, and scholarship portion of today's program. Congratulations to everyone that was recognized today. And once again, congratulations and good luck to the class of 2020. And now we're going to move on to typically kind of everyone's favorite. We're going to move on to the senior video. So sit back, relax, have a good time. Let's take a look back at the class of 2020.
I'm not prepared for the future. So many things that I just don't know. I cut my hair, bought a new shirt, new pair of shoes, and it's time to go. I finally found an apartment, signed a lease on a car this month. I can't go back to the start now. Time doesn't slow down. I'm on my own. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm putting all my things inside a box next to a toaster. That's my closest thing to closure. I can't stop this roller coaster. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm telling all my friends we'll get together next October. That's my closest thing to closure. I can't stop this roller coaster. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Never thought I'd be 20. Now 30 don't seem so far away. I know I gotta make a little money, then maybe find somebody to call my own. I'm ready, but I can't go back in time. I know it's all out of my control now, I know. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm putting all my things inside a box next to a toaster. That's my closest thing to closure. I can't stop this roller coaster. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm telling all my friends we'll get together next October. That's my closest thing to closure. I can't stop this roller coaster. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Guess my childhood is over. One day I'll be buying posters for my kids just like my parents did for me. It's never over. They'll grow up and soon enough they'll wish the time would just move slower. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm putting all my things inside a box next to a toaster. That's my closest thing to closure. I can't stop this roller coaster. I'm not ready to get older. I'm not ready to get older. Guess my childhood is over now. I'm taking down my posters and I'm telling all my friends we'll get together next October. That's my...
Let's go! He walks slowly down the street with the brim pool way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of his feet. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the sound of the beat, yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust, and another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust, hey, hey. I'm gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Thank you.
searching for a token. With the people, took the taxes to fund the evil. Sound familiar? The mindless divide us. When we need guidance, you give us the silence. It's spineless and blindless. We will bite back, not sit here smiling while they choose to attack. The student loans are the first time home. It's time to know that at the moment, the neglection of young and it's real, real scary. Being under 21, honey, we want your money. Over suspenders, you talk about peace, but then no one surrenders. From a cynical man, we don't plan. When it all goes wrong, there'll be no confession. Only a digression.
Another like me. Another like me.
times you die twice. Once when they bury you in the grave, and the second time is the last time that somebody mentions your name. So when I leave here on this earth, did I take more than I gave? Did I look out for the people, or did I do it all for fame? Legend is Exodus, searching for euphoria, trudging through the mud to find the present, no ignoring us. Got 20,000 deep up in the street like we some warriors. My mama told me never bow your head.
Whoa. I feel glorious, glorious. Got a chance to start again. I was born for this, born for this. It's who I am, I could have again. I made it through the darkest part of the night, and now I see the sunrise. Now I feel glorious, glorious. I feel glorious, glorious.
I'm feeling glorious. The crib looking victorious. Just things, they don't make you who you are. Can't pack up for you, haul and take it with you when you're gone. We posted on the porch, my family's glasses to the stars. My grandma smiling down on me like, ooh, that boy got bars. Okay, okay, yes I do. I said amen and hallelujah, let me testify to another morning, I'm on it. Won't let self get in my way. I got my breath, I got my faith, and I remember why I came.
I feel glorious, glorious.
Yeah.
I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes and we see what we've become, in the cold light of day we're a flame in the wind, not the fire that we begun. Every argument, every word we can't take back, 'cause with all that has happened, I think that we both know the way that this story ends. Then only for a minute, I want to change my mind, 'cause this just don't feel right to me. I wanna raise your spirits, I want to see you smile.
Emo chick that's broken, this that college dropout music. Every day like that, she be stupid. And my friends are all annoying, but we go dumb, yeah, we go stupid. This the 10K on the table just so we can be secluded. I'm through, I'm through, I'm through. I hate your friends and they hate me too. I'm through, I'm through, I'm through. This that hot girl bummer anthem, turn it up and throw attention. I'm through.
What's up, I'm Ryan. I'll be hitting the stinger for you guys.
Oh, after you, sir.
Let's go!
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip. Slip, slip, word upon your lip, lip, ready that you rip, rip, break me down and build me up, whatever it takes.
You, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Today, I graduated. I wish I could look you in the eyes and tell you that I'm excited. You know, maybe if things had turned out normal then I might have, but instead 4 years has led to 4 months in my house. I know I shouldn't be upset, because of course, people are dying and that's what we should be worried about, but I want to be selfish right now. I wanted to walk across that stage and give a bow. I wanted to celebrate with my friends the fact that we'd come to an end. You know, we worked hard, cried hard, and studied hard for this day. Yet it's ripped away like the same way my heartstrings are torn. What do you want me to say? Do you want me to put on a smile and say we did it? Or can I just admit that I'm upset? And I don't want to repeat myself and sound oversaturated, but hey. At least I graduated.
They say distance is relative, and relative to relatives I have, I'd say I'm relatively close to breaking down. Because right now, I feel so alone. I've been missing the elements and wishing the elephant in the room would leave and kindly close the door. I can't ignore him like before, not anymore. Oh, I miss you most at 6 feet apart when you're right outside my window but can't ride inside my car. And it hurts to know just how lovely you are and be too far away to hold but close enough to break my heart. I miss your smile, feels like miles, 6 feet apart. So far, so far, but so close, like a star out in the cosmos. Can't touch the beauty I see. That's how it feels at 6 feet. Space and time are interwoven. Well, at least that's what we're told. When I was young, I was suspicious, but it's true. Time sticks like glue. I feel so blue here missing you. So I think I'll build a time machine and go back to a time when we didn't need to measure 6 feet on the ground. When I came around, that's not allowed. I can't go back now. So I miss you most at 6 feet apart when you're right outside my window but can't ride inside my car. And it hurts.